अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम स्टार्ट करने वाले हैं चैप्टर वन इंट्रोडक्शन टू बायोलॉजी का टॉपिक सिक्स, मुस्लिम साइंटिस्ट एंड देयर कंट्रीब्यूशन। मुस्लिम साइंटिस्ट कंट्रीब्यूटेड अ लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज टू द साइंस ऑफ बायोलॉजी एंड मेडिसिन फ्रॉम 8th to 15th century। देयर व्यूज आर हाईली रिस्पेक्टेड एंड टेकन एज अथॉरिटी। सम ऑफ द फेमस मुस्लिम साइंटिस्ट आर डिस्कस्ड हियर। सो फर्स्ट वन इज जाबिर बिन हयान। जाबिर बिन हयान टाइम पीरियड वॉज From 721 to 815 AD. He was born in Iran and practiced medicine in Iraq. He introduced experimental chemistry. Therefore, he is also called as father of chemistry. His famous books in the field of biology was Al Nabatat and Al Hewan. Al Nabatat was written about plants and Al Hewan about animals. And his other interests are also in he was also an astronomer, pharmacist, physician, philosopher and engineer. Next one is Abdul Malik Asmai. His time period was from 740 to 828 AD. He was born in Basra and he was a specialist in animal sciences. His famous books were Al Khail, which is about horses, Al Ibl is about camel, Asha about sheep, and Al Wahush about wild animals. He also write a book about human body structure of human body, which was Khalqul Insan. Next one is Bu Ali Sina. Bu Ali Sina time period was from 980 to 1037 AD. He was born near Bukhara. He was the founder of medicine and also called Avicenna in West. His most famous book is Al-Qanun fil Tibb, which is about medicine. So next one is Abu Usman Umar Al-Jahiz. His time period was from 700 to 768 AD. He was born in Iraq and he was a Muslim scholar in Arabic literature. He also wrote book in biology. One was Al-Hewan, in which he described the seasonal migration of fish in invertebrates and life system of ant. Al-Hewan kitab ke andar Abu Usman ne river tigris mein fishes ki migration ka zikr kiya, seasonal migration jo hoti hai uska zikr kiya, aur uske ilawa ant ka life system bhi discuss kiya hai. Next one is Al-Farabi. His time period was from 870 to 950 AD. He was a renowned hakim and biologist. वो अपने ज़माने के जाने माने हकीम और biologist थे. His famous books was किताबुल नबतात, which is about plants, and किताबुल हैवानात, which is about animals. Next one is अब्दुल कासिम अली ज़हरवी, also called अबुल कैसस in the West. His time period was from 936 to 1004 AD. He was a great Muslim surgeon and also famous for the removal of stone from urinary bladder. His book name was Al-Tasrif. Al-Tasrif is composed of 30 volumes in which he described various aspects of surgical treatments based on the operations performed by him, including the removal of stone from the urinary bladder, dissection of animals, and surgery of the eye, ear, and throat. So next one is Ibnul Haytham. His time period was from 965 to 1039 AD, and he was born in Basra. He was an ophthalmologist, means eye specialist, and he corrected the Greek concept of vision that retina is the seat of vision. उन्होंने एक ग्रीक कॉन्सेप्ट था जिसके मुताबिक ये कहा जाता था कि जब भी हमें कोई चीज़ निकल नज़र आती है आँख से, तो वो आँखों से जो रेज निकलती हैं उसकी वजह से नज़र आती है. जबकि इब्नुल हेतम ने इस कॉन्सेप्ट को ठीक किया था कि हमारी आंख के अंदर जो इनर लेयर होती है रेटिना, वो पार्ट है आई का जो सामने वाले इमेज को फोकस करके और हमें देखने में मदद देता है. तो मीन हमारी आंख जहाँ से देख सकती है वो पार्ट है रेटिना. हिज फेमस बुक्स वाज किताबुल मनाजिर एंड मिजानुल हिकमा. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज अली बिन ईसा. His time period was from 940 to 1010 AD, and he was born in Baghdad. He was also an ophthalmologist, means eye specialist, and worked on the function, structure, and diseases of eye. His famous book was Tashkiratul Kahaleen, in which he described about 130 diseases of eye, and his book was translated into many European languages. Last one is Ibnul Nafis. His time period was from 1213 to 1288. He was a Muslim anatomist and he described the blood circulation in human body. He also worked in medicine and his famous book was Shamil fil Altib, which is about medicine. So these are the Muslim scientists and their contribution in biology. For further detailing, you can read it from your textbook. Thank you.